play in the Leeds side that can open up other teams. And I think he should get hold of the game by the scruff of the neck.
That's Gary McAllister. What about David Batty?
Dave's the old, you know, he's been likened to Billy Bremner, and he doesn't get the goals that Billy used to get. But he is that terrier-like. He gets tackles in. He's a clean player. You know, he's everything he does so early, sees things early, passes the ball early, doesn't try anything that's flash, and he's an inspiration to all of Leeds players.
That little statistic there has never been past the fourth round with Leeds in the FA Cup. It's only once in 16 years that Leeds have been past that stage, which is an incredible statistic. Alan Smith, the Arsenal striker, just a couple of goals this season. He's due one, do you think?
I think he would like to get one. He is their way out. You know, if they're in any trouble, Arsenal, that's what they look for. They look for the big man, knock it up to him, and get Wright, Merson playing off him. And it's good. It's good to have a player like that. But I don't think he'd be happy, and George would be happy with the amount of goals he scored.
We're in the company of the former Leeds skipper, Terry Yorath. We've live football on Sky Sports tonight from Elland Road at Leeds United against Arsenal next. The one or two hardy Arsenal supporters making the trip north tonight. Good to see. Good evening to you too. I was going to say it's good to see them in such good spirits. Let's meet the commentators this evening, Andy Gray and Martin Tyler. Good evening to you both.
Hello, Richard. Well, we're in good spirits as well. We've just been down by the dressing rooms there, and it's a real game of cat and mouse when these two teams meet, Andy, isn't it? All sorts of little huddles going on in corners down below.
Well, we saw that last week, didn't we, in the first game. We wondered tactically what the managers were going to produce. Howard Wilkinson altered his shape of his side slightly, and I think George Graham feels that he has to do something tonight, so I think we can look for something again, something special. I think probably this time from Arsenal and to the way they adopt it tactically in this game.
But they are under strength, aren't they? How much is that going to be a factor?
Well, it will be a factor, because in games like this, experience is vital, I feel. But what George knows he has, he's got kids in there, and especially in a crucial midfield area, he's got kids he's put in there, and he knows that they are going to work till they drop. They are going to make people like David Batty, McAllister, Strachan, Speed's job as difficult as they possibly can. And if they can do that, they'll do a job for Arsenal.
How do you feel Arsenal will be coming back here now? Back in November, they were really thumped 3-0. They've won only one of 10 league games since that experience. Do you think they can rid their minds of it and go out and give a real show?
They're good professionals, Martin. They want to win this game badly, Arsenal. Speaking to George, speaking to everybody, they feel they can win it, and that's what they're here to do. I don't expect any problems with their attitude at all.
Richard, it's all yours.
Martin, thank you. Mike Curry's been outside Elland Road getting the thoughts of fans that are on the way in this evening.
After the first game, I think Leeds are still on top at Highbury, but today I think Leeds are going to win 3 or 4 nil. Because if we don't, our season's going to be finished. So I think we're going to win 3 or 4 nil tonight. We'll show them how Leeds can play. All the papers have been crucifying us, but tonight you just watch what happened. Leeds will crucify them.
I think it should be another quite tight match. A lot of people are talking about Wright being the main factor in coming back, but I think it's going to be settled in midfield, where I think Leeds might have the advantage.
I've got a feeling it'll be 1-0 to Arsenal after coming back from 2-0 down. I've got a feeling Leeds might crumble away. 1-0 to Arsenal, Ian Wright.
I'm Wright, coming back from a three-match ban. Different win for Arsenal, a couple of goals for Ian Wright. 3-1.
It is going to be a close game, but Arsenal are going to nick it. There isn't any doubt about that, with Wright being back. He's the mainspring of the Arsenal team.
Terry Yorath, former Leeds skipper, the Welsh team manager, is our guest this evening. You live just up the road, Terry, so I wouldn't expect you to back against Leeds United. I mean, what do you think?
It's going to be a difficult game for Leeds. I think mainly because they have to win it. Otherwise, everything's gone for the season. I think Leeds will win the game. I think there's two areas of the pitch. The midfield area, where Andy's just said, counts a lot. Leeds have got the experience, and if they can control that early on, then I feel they can win it.
They haven't been so good on their travels, but just one team, Norwich, has stopped them scoring here in 17 league and cup matches. So, are they still looking like champions at Elland Road?
I've seen them here a few times this season, and to be truthful, no. You know, they've been very patchy. But when they're on song, you know, it's good to watch. People get forward to help the strikers out, which, you know, the four players in midfield have got a licence to do that, especially Speed. It's at the back where they've had their problems.
Yes, they've been leaking goals, haven't they?
Well, you know, they've started the season off without a genuine right back, and they've tried quite a few people there. The two central defenders then had a little bit of a wobble, which I think affected the goalkeeper, and they started to leak goals. And if Wright, Merson, and Smith are on form tonight, then that department of the Leeds side has got to be spot on.
It is a fascinating prospect, isn't it? Well,
one worth watching.
Very much so. And this is the story of the FA Cup so far for Leeds and Arsenal. Leeds were stunned when Gary Nelson put Charlton 1-1 at Elland Road. You could feel the relief when Gary's speed forced a replay, equalising 2 minutes later. Yeovil had hopes of upsetting Arsenal, but a hat-trick by Ian Wright ended the dreams of the team from the Vauxhall Conference. Arsenal cruised to the fourth round, despite Paul Batty's consolation.
Number 20,
Arsenal.
Number 17,
we'll play Leeds United or Charlton Athletic.
Business to be finished then. Gary Speed gave Leeds an early lead, then Peter Garland contributed to his team's downfall when Leeds and Charlton met for the second time. Although the First Division team fought back with a Darren Pitcher goal, Gary McAllister finally finished them off. Then last week, hopes of a classic cup tie were more than justified when Ray Parlour pulled one back for Arsenal after Speed and Chapman had given Leeds a 2-0 cushion. Merson produced some magic in the 81st minute, which brought Arsenal back from the brink. Now they meet again. It's George Graham and Howard Wilkinson head-to-head tonight. Wasn't that a great shot? George Graham and Howard Wilkinson exchanging pleasantries after the 2-2 at Highbury.